Hi, and welcome to Marc on Sailing. I'm Marc.
And I'm Marc. And today, we're going to talk about bearings. To be more precise, Marc is going to show us how cross bearings work. So, without further ado, handing off to you, Marc.
Today's topic is bearings. Bearings are used to estimate your position. This is one main objective of navigation, to know where you are. And for this, we use the most simple bearing, which is the cross bearing. There are various types of bearings, but this is the most simple one and the one which is most often used. To make a cross bearing, you have to have two points on the land or buoys which you have on your chart. I took the start point lighthouse and the Bill of Portland lighthouse. So what you do now on board is you take your bearing compass, aim from your boat to the lighthouse and then plot your bearing. I did this in my mind now and now I put it in my navigation sheet. I put an arrow, which means bearing. Then I put the name, start point, lighthouse, and then I put which angle I had for the bearing. For example, 2.52 degrees, and then the second bearing to the Bill of Portland. Again, the same procedure. It's a bearing, so an arrow, then Bill, and then I had 0.12 degrees. This is what you measured with your compass, and now you have to plot it in the chart to get your position. I start with the start point and 252 degrees. Now it's the same procedure as we had on our last video, measuring courses. It's exactly the same, only we call it here a bearing. Now we go from east to west, and the tip of our ruler is always pointing down when we use it. That's to avoid mistakes. Now that we measure from east to west, we use the red numbers. So the 0 on the meridian and the 252 also on the meridian. Then that's now the right angle. Now we have to move it to start point, a little bit below and a little bit to the left. So first to the left, and then we switch the second ruler and then below. It's still the same angle, only on different positions. And then we draw a long line from start point lighthouse to somewhere where our position will be. That's our first bearing. We can draw here again an arrow to the lighthouse, which means bearing, and write a number next to it, 252 degrees. So then the second bearing is 0.12 degrees to Bill of Portland. Same procedure, 0 to 12 degrees is somewhere up there, so going from west to east. So again, the black numbers. We put the 0 on the meridian, then the ruler on 12 degrees, like this, and then we move it to our lighthouse. As we see now, the first bearing is not long enough, but that's no problem. We draw the second one. And then we make the first one a little bit longer, like this. Same angle again. And now we have a cross here. And as this is an observed position, which we are 100% sure that we are, we put a circle around it And this means observed position. So this is reliable. And then again, we have our time, which we also plot here next to the bearings. For example, 11:32. And this is also plotted in the chart, 11:32. And this is our cross bearing. And now we have a position. And with this position, we can work for our next steps. For example, we want to go here to the Isle of Wight. Then we take our ruler, plot the course, and again, take the course out of the chart, like we have seen on the last video. Plot it here on top of the chart, and then we know which course to steer with our compass, and we can safely navigate through shallow waters.
Thank you so much for watching. If you liked the video, like, maybe even subscribe, and you can hit that little notification bell down in the lower right corner. You can also follow us on Twitter and Facebook, links down in the description below. And as always, fair winds to you.